Are these grapes? I have no idea. They look like a grapevine. There are clusters of what look like berries or some kind of, well, it looks like a grape to me, little tiny grapes. I haven't been watering this. This is a weed, or it's a wild plant. It's growing on this tree and over this fence. They still look like little grapes to me. And we are blessed with the rain today, so maybe they'll plump up a little bit more. How do you like my tomato plants? I'm having a bad year with tomatoes. This is probably one of my worst years ever, which is surprising because I had 45 plants at the beginning of spring. A lot of my tomato plants have died. I'm not sure what it is. Some kind of virus or not enough good water. I'm not sure. But not all my plants are doing poorly. I do have some left that are doing okay. For the end of July, my total harvest of tomatoes is about 3 pounds, which is a very small amount for 45 plants. Now this is probably one of my best plants. And I still have never tasted the tomatoes from this plant. Anyway, it's called Omar's Lebanese. So we just had a rain. So everything's wet right now. These tomato plants look very healthy. They're growing in some new compost that I picked up this spring. However, I don't see any tomatoes growing on these plants. One of my main problems with the tomatoes is I've had a lot of animal problems. Squirrels, I think, are the biggest culprit eating my tomatoes. I saw a squirrel the other day when I was walking into the fenced area here. A squirrel saw me coming and climbed up this tree and then looked down at me with a tomato in its mouth. Every day I find bits and pieces of chewed up tomatoes on the ground. But today I didn't because I don't have any tomatoes. There aren't any even close to being ripe right now. Well, except for the cherry tomatoes. I do have some of those coming in. I get a few of those every day. But animals keep eating those too. I see little bits and pieces of the cherry tomatoes. I do get some cherry tomatoes. Many times I see them ripening on the vine and I decide to leave them on the plant for one more day. Let them keep ripening up to perfection. I come out the next day and they're gone. Some animal swipes them. So here's an example of what I see almost every day. Somebody bit off the cherry tomato there and left a little some evidence behind to let me know that I lost one. Maybe a turtle or a squirrel bit, or a bird bit off the fruit and then said, "Hey, I was here." When I come out here every day to check on the plants, I usually pick up some free cat treats. Grass. So the tomatoes aren't doing very well, but I've got a pretty good watermelon patch going. And I have some healthy okra plants too. Happy to see watermelons growing. There's another watermelon. There are several growing in here. There's another one behind it. Look at that, two watermelons growing side by side. There's another one hiding in there. A couple of the first watermelon that appeared ended up rotting. There's one there that is rotting. I decided to leave it. Now, it looks ugly, but I'm thinking there's a lot of moisture trapped inside that fruit. So if the plant decided to stop growing, maybe the plant can benefit by reabsorbing the liquid, the sugar, the water that's inside that fruit. Maybe it can divert that energy store into the other fruit that are growing. Here's an update on my apple tree, grown from a seed. It's still growing, very slow, but it's there, looking okay. My little girl came out here to keep me company. And here is an update on the fig tree. All I did was dug a hole and put a stem of a fig tree in here. And it looks like it's taken off, finally. The leaves that were originally on the branch died and dried up. But now we have new growth here. So we got a brand new leaf coming out. So we got our first signs of life coming out of the stick in the mud. Don't be a stick in the mud. Maybe you should be a stick in the mud. Anyway, put a stick in the mud and it grows a whole new tree. I hope that this will take off and really start growing before winter kicks in. So our cat is a strictly indoor cat. She never goes outside. But she still likes to eat grass. So you can see that, well, look at this. I mean, she likes grass more than she likes cat food, I think. I think grass helps to keep cats healthy. Must have some vitamins and minerals in there that they need. Oh, she likes the seeds too.